Yeah, and even with the album, you know, Shoma Josie's on there, Nadia Nakai is on
Okay.
there. I'm missing out a lot of people. My New
Yeah.
World Star is on it.
Oh, dope.
And the list goes on and on and on.
Dope.
But the album, guys, is amazing. Pelo Bala's even on it.
Okay, dope.
I'm giving away everything.
Welcome to the DMs podcast with your boy Cybersonic. I got a special guest up in the building, Gigi LeMaine, the queen of hip hop. I call her the queen of hip hop. Been a fan for years now.
Thank
Girl, you
you.
out in the streets, we've been trying to lock you down.
Yeah, I guess the universe hadn't aligned yet, and I always like to come out to party for a reason.
Yeah,
So
yeah,
yeah.
yeah. I love that, party for a reason, because
Yeah.
I guess you don't want to just be out here for the sake of being out here.
Absolutely not. I
Yeah.
mean, the best advice I ever got was from a brother of mine, Nasty C, when he was just
Okay.
like, super important for you to know why you're in a certain place at a certain time.
I love that.
You don't need to overexpose yourself.
Yeah,
Like, only
yeah.
come out when you have to.
Yeah,
So
yeah.
yeah.
Interesting. When you Google search your name and results pop up, are you satisfied with those, what pops up?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, lots of celebrations around a beverage company that
yeah.
I have, you know, started to partner with. The Could You Cups campaign I'm doing with Wyclef Jean and
okay.
a few other international artists and
yeah.
brands
yeah.
to, you know, the upcoming single and
yeah.
album. So, yeah.
Girl, how do you lock down Wyclef? Wyclef the Fugees, nah?
Wyclef locked me down.
We global like that. We global like that.
Wyclef locked
yeah,
me down.
Yeah,
yeah,
you know, she
yeah.
locked you down. No,
yeah.
he definitely locked you
yeah.
down. Talking about global, I love, and this is just coming from a fan perspective, like the Mojo, that Mojo record was hot.
Thank you.
And Atlanta, that was hot.
Thank you.
That
was hot in Atlanta.
Yeah.
We were actually out there before the country closed down.
Okay, cool.
I'm hoping to get back there as well because there's so many artists and, you know, new people to engage with and work with. I loved that space. I also love the European
okay,
space.
Cool.
And I think you guys are going to be seeing a lot of me collaborating with other artists
Beautiful.
Outside of the country. I'm just a little bored right now
yeah.
and I just want to experience different people and different cultures and
Definitely.
Different sounds. Yeah.
Definitely. When you're all over these international spots, right?
Like, yeah.
What is that South African thing about us? Like, when you get overseas, they just don't get. They're like,
the food.
Okay.
Yeah, the
Say
food is whack. So, I mean, like, we've got the best food, guys.
Facts.
Us in Nigeria have probably got the best food.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
No, I absolutely hated
yeah.
everything.
Yeah.
In the States, I hated
yeah.
the meatloaf. I hated the tacos. I hated the nachos.
Girl, tacos.
I didn't like anything. And
okay,
that was
cool.
like on Times Square. So, I mean,
yeah.
yeah, no.
yeah. Look, Gigi, real talk, you come across as a strong person. I want to understand, like, for a person to be around you, what type of caliber of person, like, who do I need to be around you?
I'm a very energy-driven
okay,
person,
no? okay.
but I think that's just something everybody says nowadays. Ooh, energies
okay.
and vibrations.
Yeah.
And it just goes a very, very long way.
Yeah.
I'm usually never wrong
yeah.
when you're in my space.
Yeah.
But for somebody to be around me,
yeah.
I always say, it's a soul connection.
Okay.
It's a soul connection. It's equally beneficial.
Yeah.
If there's nothing that I'm receiving
yeah.
from you,
yeah.
then you and I have no business being around each other.
Yeah.
And I'm as simple and as blunt as that. I think I've always lived in spaces where people have always wanted to take from me.
Okay.
Whether it was sitting in the club and wanting to pop bottles with me.
Okay.
Or feeling like you could take advantage of me.
Okay.
And I think I've grown up now and I'm emotionally intelligent
Facts.
Enough to understand that not everyone needs to be around
Facts.
You. You don't always have to be around everyone.
Facts.
Got very, very, a very, very small circle of friends.
Facts.
And I'm happy.
What type of honey irritates you? Describe
it. That is this is gonna be an interesting interview. What type of honey irritates me? A honey who isn't self-reliant, you
okay.
know? I think I'm super big on yes, date on your level. If you want to date above your level, but don't expect him to take care of you. I said to someone, I was like the other day and we were discussing, you know,
yeah.
what kind of man you'd want in your life.
Okay.
And I really, really don't understand women who want men to do everything for
okay.
them and then still build a home with him.
Mm.
Because if your man is out there working in construction and something happens to his legs
yeah.
and you can't look after him
Facts.
Or the household,
Facts.
There was no point in establishing that relationship
Facts.
Because you'll be upset.
Facts.
You will never be fulfilled
Facts.
Because you went into the relationship not understanding what you wanted. So for me, it's definitely a woman who is not self-reliant that gets to me. I don't like, I don't like that whole like, blesser walking in, popping bottles, like, we're gonna see how we get home, children.
And you see a lot
really
of those.
Grates my tits for days.
And you see a lot of those. I mean, being in the club scene, you see a lot of those, and just, you know, being, you know, a national artist yourself, you see a lot of those.
Yeah.
What do you hate about the club scene? I'll talk about that. I hate the club scene, personally.
I think the club scene, I'm not in the club scene unless I'm working or I'm out with people who've like invited me and they want to host me. But I just, it's very superficial. It's very superficial. You know, I've never understood the popping bottles on a Friday and then Monday you're asking me for Uber or taxi fare. Like, I've never understood that. There's a girl I know and I had to cut off because every time you bump into her in the club, but you don't have a proper job, you're not trying to grow up emotionally or spiritually, you constantly take from people, but you're in the club drinking and partying. You know everybody in the club scene, but you're not making money. Why are you in the club? This is somebody who probably, like, the amount of time we spend in 9-to-5s and cutting deals, that's the amount of time she spends in the clubs. And she's okay with literally getting somebody else's bottle and pouring. And I'm just like, what? When are you going to change? You've been 100%, doing this for years.
100%.
So for me, it's just how superficial it is.
Yeah.
Like, even with status, you like, I'm still going to get drunk the same way as you.
Yeah.
Whether it's Ace of Spades or Gin. Like, I'm still going to get drunk like you. And for me, it's just ridiculous at how somebody's willing to spend like 40, 50K. I'm just thinking, that's somebody's tuition, my dude. But that's just me. I'm boring like that. That's just me.
Gigi, you're a Vitz graduate, man. Like, I understand why. And I can get that academic vibe from you. But I want to talk about your spiritual journey. Like, how did that come about?
I was 11. I started seeing things.
Okay. By the way, you know when you Google search Gigi LeVay?
Sangoma. Oh my God. That's the new one. Like, like, the worst part is having to like date because I see things before they happen. Like, it's so annoying. Like, I can't just date anyone anymore.
So if I date you, like you're gonna see things about me.
I'm gonna call you when you're at McDonald's with notes. Okay, like, and it's so strange because they always think like I've got somebody following them.
Okay, cool.
Okay, maybe I do in a certain spiritual route, but like, spiritually, like, that gift has always been in my lineage, both mom and dad. But I think my mom went through a phase in her life where she just wanted to detach from that. And I mean, she has her own reasons for it, but it's so nice to see her grow again in spirit because there were practices and traditions that she grew up around.
Definitely.
And I think us as young people right now becoming super enlightened.
Yeah.
There were a lot of things that were happening in my life that were like really strange, you know, from...
This is before the blow up?
Before the blow up. Okay. Like, just seeing things. Yeah. Anyone who went to boarding school with me would know that I'd like continuously complain about like seeing people walk around. Like, it was crazy. People thought I was crazy. Like dreaming about things and then they kind of happen. And what happens with these callings is when you ignore them, you begin to see that like it messes with you more and more. Ended up getting into wrong relationships, wrong friendships, situations that I shouldn't have been in.
Yeah.
And I went to go and do what I needed to do.
And it got explained to you, basically.
Yes. And every time I'd go to people, they'd tell me the same thing.
Okay.
Like, and it wasn't like just the odd Sangoma. It was like the white clairvoyants.
Okay,
it was
cool.
Like the shaman from India. It was like weird people I just bump into even in the performance setting.
Okay, cool.
And they'll be like, there's something up
with you. There's a vibe around you.
And after I landed up in a hospital in 2018, somebody reached out to me and they were like, when are you going to do this?
Yeah.
You know what's going on with you. And that's when I was like, okay, fine, I need to explore.
Okay, cool.
So I went to initiation school, disappeared for a little bit during COVID.
Yeah. No, we all had to.
Yeah.
We all had to.
So I disappeared and I came back and I'm happier. I know who I am. And also, like, just to anybody who is watching, listening to this, I'd always say, like, this thing is not a clout thing.
It's not a clout thing,
It's not a clout thing. And it often affects people who are influential.
Yeah.
People who are, especially now, because I honestly believe that in the African context, our ancestors are coming back to claim us.
Okay, cool.
So they're going to use a Gigi Lemin.
Okay.
They're going to use a Boiti Tulo.
100%.
They're going to use a Latoya Magene 100%. To get as much of your attention as you need to get until you realize your calling, or until you simply follow tradition, even if you don't have a calling. So, I mean, we're called to heal in different ways. I heal through music. I heal spiritually.
Okay.
I see spiritually. And, you know, there have been focal players in my life. I mean, Gugu Ndabezitha, Cindy Kruger. There have been 100%. Some very, 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 like, pivotal figures in me discovering my gift.
100%.
And how I maneuver around it. But I am very spiritual.
Okay,
I can't even, like... I can't even dribble niggas, okay? Like, the people I walk with hate that. Like, they hate that. Like, it's pick one. It's like one at a time.
Yeah.
There's so many things I had to stop doing. Like, even from a dietary perspective.
Okay, cool.
Can't eat pork, can't eat this, can't eat that.
Okay.
But man, I'm so happy.
Okay. And I see that.
I'm really happy. I'm tired, but I'm happy.
But you're happy. Talking about dudes, relationships. When was the last time you cried because of love?
3 months ago.
Was it that bad? What's happening with your guy?
Like,
was he frightened, or you were just like...
No, like, it was just happening? Like, it was just like a stupid fight.
Okay.
Like, it was a stupid fight. We figured it out. But like, it was, yeah.
So you cried, like, during, like, you those girls that like,
yeah, like, but not everyone will know.
Cool,
but
okay.
I cry, then I go through a little like hoey phase on Instagram where I'm like thirst trapping. So every time you see Gigi thirst trapping, it's because she's got the chesties. I noticed that for some reason I thirst trap when I'm But that was 3 months ago.
Woo. Okay. You got tattoos?
5.
When did you get your first tattoo?
I was 21 in a house with MT.
Okay, that's a story. Okay, in a house with MT, what's happening?
In a house with MT, artists were chilling. I remember the Turbanites were there.
Okay.
Like, just a whole lot of us. No, we were actually in Midrand. And yeah, there was a tattoo artist.
Was MT also getting tatted?
Yeah, of course.
Okay, cool.
And I remember the next day was like, I think it was the Sama nomination something.
Yeah.
And he had to be there the next day.
Oh, okay.
But like the whole night, people were just like getting tats.
Okay, cool.
I think there were like 4 tattoo artists there.
Dope.
And yeah, my best friend and I ended up getting tat.
What does it mean? What did
the
you get?
I got the Eye of Ra.
Okay.
Yeah, so all my tats are Egyptian.
Okay.
I've got Cleopatra on my sternum area.
Dope.
Eye of Ra on my left ankle. I've got a trident though, which is not Egyptian, but mermaids use that to hunt.
Girl, you're deep.
I've got like the ankh on my shoulder.
You like on some Erica Badu
type of vibe. And then I've got the 2 Egyptian sphinx cats across my... Yeah, that's the biggest tattoo I have across across my waist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Talking about summers, nominations just dropped a couple of weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
Do the summers still matter? You think it matters to you, to the industry?
I think the summers matter to whoever wants them to matter. I mean, I'm a member of RISA.
Okay.
I will submit when my album drops, but I've never been consumed by awards.
Okay, cool.
Never been consumed by awards because I do it for the love.
Mm.
I honestly do. And for those who it means everything to, kudos to you.
Okay.
They're going to be winners. They're going to be losers.
Yeah.
But don't let it take anything away from you.
Yeah.
I mean, Makazi for one. Makazi had one of the biggest albums.
Definitely.
I don't, and I'm not just saying it because I was on the
album.
Makazi
was crazy.
Yeah, she was like,
crazy.
Who wasn't listening to Makazi or watching her performances or see her?
Fact.
And for the fact that that happened to her, and I rated her as one of the most successful artists even throughout the COVID situation, and she doesn't get rewarded for that, shouldn't take away anything from her. I think she's amazing. I think she's strong. And I think the summers are more for major record labels. I don't think they're for us who are like independent.
Yeah, definitely.
So I mean, if you're in a major, you stand a bigger chance of, you know, being recognized. And that's okay. But if you're indie and you're pushing your own thing, don't let that be your world, because
100%.
There are people around that table who are not necessarily there to represent
100%.
You. And until that happens,
100%.
I don't think people should care that much.
But you're in those Risa circles. Like, what do you like? This is me assuming now, because you're indie. Whatever the situation may be, do you like what have the chats been said there? What are the chats? I mean,
exactly, what are the chats? Do we have, you know, I know it's crazy that I'm going to say this now, but like, and it might be like a little off topic, but I just saw something by Julius Malema on Twitter speaking about the energy of the youth and how like it's time for us to step forward and really start to like transform a lot of things.
100%.
You know, I worry for people like Blackie, who are absolutely amazing artists, and whether, you know, him winning an award or not winning an award will, you know, define anything different. And we need to get to a space where that doesn't even matter. And even if we consider it to matter, we need young voices in there.
Definitely.
Who are going to speak to the streets. People who are on the streets of Bramfontein, people who are on the streets and in the club situations and doing all these things and changing the game. You know, there's so many different things that people have ignored when it comes to some of these award ceremonies. They've been the same. And the reason why we constantly, like, I don't know how many times I've seen in the American context new artists being broken into the industry at an award show.
We need a freshman cover. We need culture. Yeah, 100%.
It's always the same faces, same people, same company.
Yeah.
Like, it's just so obvious sometimes. Like, oh, these people are from here and these people are from here. Okay.
It's a click.
It's like, you know, and it's got nothing to do with the artist as well. You know, it's more to do with the back end and how I can't wait for young energy in the South African context to seep into all these different environments, into, you know, the state's government and how 100%. It's run, and into the music industry, because that actually ties into a lot of things that happen politically.
Music is political. 100%.
You know? So I can't wait for that to happen, because I see, you know, with corporates, and people complain about private companies all the time, but we're seeing Vinny on Doritos ads.
100%.
You know what I'm saying? Like, this means that private companies.
I love that.
Yes.
Man, I'm vouching for Vinny all the way.
Private companies are noticing that there is 100%. A shift, and there are young people doing amazing things.
100%.
And we're going to complain about private companies.
100%.
But what is government doing for younger people?
100%.
Who is representing these young independent artists at the Salmons? Like, for me, there's so much that needs to change.
And I like the way you tied it in with politics and music, right?
Yeah.
And I'm of the opinion it starts with politics.
Mm.
Like, we lack a lot of young people in politics in general, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And we could have a whole conversation around that, but it really, because the political setup inspires the social consciousness of the country.
Exactly.
So when you see a 30-something-year-old minister of telecommunications, you're like, okay, that's dope.
Yeah,
like,
I can do that one
dude was, I was with that dude at Vitz at UJ.
Yeah.
Like, I know that dude. So
that guy speaks
to me. Yeah,
I don't know. Like, I really wish. Yeah, there's no progress if we don't have, you know, the zest and the energy of young people
100%.
Combined with the wisdom
100%.
Of all that we all need each other.
We all need each other.
I can't wait for governments and people in powerful spaces to understand that.
Yeah.
Like, it's not a fight to overthrow the elders.
Yeah.
It's,
we ain't beefing with y'all.
We need a seat at the table. We need a seat at the table.
We need a little something.
You know, same way, you know, our elders had so much time to see, hide, and do all these different things for our leaders.
100%.
You know, back in a time where we were fighting for the liberation of this country.
100%.
We deserve to have a seat at the table with you. And this time, we look like you.
In closing, no one's going to give it to us. We need to take it. That's all I'm saying.
Absolutely.
Your top three favorite apps on your phone.
Top three favorite apps on my phone have to be Instagram. It's the queasy.
There's trapping dudes.
Instagram.
Yeah.
Okay, it doesn't matter. There's this new one called I'll tell you now. It's called,
cool.
Like, I've been messing with it a lot. It's like a cool video app.
Oh yeah?
It's called Beatleap.
Beatleap.
You create like cool videos,
you
put songs behind it.
Oh, that's dope.
And for the ladies, Beauty Plus.
Oh, Beauty Plus. What's that about?
The ultimate catfishes.
Okay, cool.
I'm putting my girls on now.
What's
so if you're not happy with how you look, download Beauty Plus and fix your picture.
We got you, girls.
You will thank me.
Your phone is full. Your phone mirror is full. And you need to take another picture, right?
Yeah.
And you've got three photos that you need to delete to take this other picture. You've got a photo with Blackie, with Mikasa, and with Brie Brassy.
Yeah.
Who you deleting?
In the spirit of public relations and the fact that I'm dropping a single with the two, Bree,
yeah,
you support me, yeah, so I'm gonna delete Bree because she understands.
Yeah,
she understands that we kind of need the boys right now. Yeah. So, no offense to Bree Biase, but like I'll probably delete her so that I can keep the boys for the single dropping.
Let's talk about the single.
Yeah,
what's that about? I'm excited about that. New music finding in 2021. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So Feeling You is, I don't know. I'm in a space where I want to collaborate with the unexpected.
Okay.
And I think Mikasa's, like, they've never worked with 100%. A female rapper.
100%.
They've never worked with many rappers. And, you know, they were open to doing that. Blackie is doing amazingly well. Yeah. I love what he stands for. I think he's so true to himself. Yeah. And it was just like, what happens when you create this part of, you know, legendary status, a female pioneer, and then you have the king of the new wave?
Yeah. Oh, Blackie. I love Blackie. Blackie's dope.
Oh, Blackie's amazing.
Oh, my goodness.
So what would happen if you mix those three into one pot and Feeling You was born?
Okay. Hold up. Before we get into that, how do you pick your people? Who put that together? Do you sit, you mind map it out? Okay. You do your spiritual, strategic, media relations. How do you put that?
It's SNS. It's spirit and strategy.
Okay.
Ooh. So that's how I work. It's SNS. Spirit and strategy.
That's the IP. That's the IP.
So if I connect to you in a spiritual way, I can connect to people without meeting them.
Facts.
And then obviously strategy to say, like, I've listened to these people since I was growing up as a kid.
Okay, cool.
I know how much they've done. I would really like to go down in the history books with them.
Definitely.
And I know they're looking to work with younger acts.
Definitely.
And let me do that.
Definitely.
And with Blackie, spiritually, he's just an amazing person.
He's dope.
And strategy is pretty simple. Like, mm-hmm. being in studio with him, he even taught me things I didn't know about myself.
Mm.
Like how great I sound trapping.
Yeah.
How great I sound like singing.
Yeah.
Like, it's crazy how much you can learn from people if you're actually willing to learn.
Yeah.
So for me, the SNS has always worked for me. Same
dope.
Has gone with King Monada,
dope.
With Dira and Mark in the future, in the past with Makadzi, and even with the album, you know, Shoma Josie's on there, Nadia Nakai is on there. I'm missing out a lot of people. My new world star is on it.
Oh, dope.
And the list goes on and on and on.
Dope.
But the album, guys, is amazing. Pelo Bala's even on it.
Okay, dope.
I'm giving away everything, but you guys are gonna see the pre-order.
You're getting exclusive on DM's podcast.
Actually,
so subscribe. We're getting exclusive.
The pre-order goes out as soon as the song drops.
Okay, cool. Drops on Friday.
Friday.
So the pre-order starts dropping on Friday too.
Pre-order drops on Friday for the album. You can see who I worked with.
Dope.
Some international acts as well as some local acts.
Dope.
And I did that all alone as an independent artist.
Oh my goodness.
So if there's anyone listening out there and you still feel like you need, hey, talk to my man. It does not work
it
in this day and age.
It doesn't work like that now.
Sit down, visualize what you want, and go for it. Like, DM the person. Haha, look at that. DM the person. Like, go out and look for them.
Facts.
And let it manifest.
Facts.
I never thought in my whole life, as a young girl who was going to school and hearing music in a taxi, that today I'd have a song with Mikasa. Yo, what's up, guys? It's your girl, Gigi LeMain, a.k.a. Inkosa Zania Sekasi. And thank you so much to the DMs Podcast for having me. Don't forget to subscribe to their channel. And of course, stream, follow. And if you have comments, don't forget to leave them at the bottom. Stream me. It's your girl. The album is dropping. The single is dropping. Everything is popping. It's the new wave, baby. Yes.
What's good, everybody? It's your boy, Cybersonic, right here on the DM Podcast. Shout out to my team, D-Roll, the director. And shout out to our sponsors, man, for the food. We had Gigi LeMain come through. She loved the food. She's on a starch diet, but you know, the pizza shop got you. Shout out to KIP Pizzas, man. The best pizzas in town. They had one Elof at Elof Street, Marshalltown, Johannesburg. Shout out to my boy, KPI Pizza. Black business, we proud of you, my boy. Keep it going. Let's keep grubbing. You heard.